Walnut Creek is hella lame, so I like claiming it because it sucks, but it's my hometown, and no matter what, I'm gonna always love my hometown. And like having Oakland be, you know, 10 miles away, San Francisco's 20 miles, but then you have just like secluded, quiet, beautiful, you know, place to go hang out at. It's really epic. This has never been talked about before, but like during this time, I had like a real bad anorexic problem. But height 5'9", 125 pounds. This is the night of the That's Life premiere. Straight and completely 100% sober. I've never had a beer, never been drunk, never taken drugs. I had a chance to smoke weed with Didi Ramone. I said, nah, man, I'm cool. So here's me with Didi Ramone. This is me at 15. Didi actually snuck me in and said I was part of his band so I could get into the show. He had me singing, I think it was Blitzkrieg Bop on stage. I guess I just like things eerie and supernatural and kind of macabre. And always as a kid, I really liked like horror comics and horror movies and just things like gory and kind of creepy things. Seeing the crow on the skull with a black rose, or like this one I like. It's the head of John the Baptist. So that's pretty basic, alphabetized, A through Z, compilations. All these drawers are all filled as well. They all start off from A through Z. The ones on the floor are ones that I've DJed over the last, you know, past few months. My wife and I, we do a DJ night. 13,
15.
Discovered records, punk rock just kind of took over. Everything just changed. And like, you discover that shit the first time where I did, I was like, you take it to the fullest, you know? Like, there's no boundaries. You're like, I'm gonna go fucking nuts. And so April 11th, 1994, that's when like my life was forever changed. That's the day I walked to the skate shop and I got my first complete.
Oh my God.
The first feeble I ever did was right there.
Honey, was that the bomb?
Here I am, even like on Thanksgiving, like I had to bring my skateboard. And now that is my life. Nothing else mattered. I just wanted to skate.
This is when I was like 15, 16 right here. First time breaking an arm and a leg at the same time. And of course I'm like stoked, like, yeah, eat shit. So Jamie Thomas filmed that one right there. Yeah, I broke my arm after because I didn't do it like properly. He's like, do it again. I wanted to wear a chain wallet. I wanted to, you know, go eat shit and come home, you know, covered in blood and mud, and go do it all again the next day. So that's like the video that got me like on foundation, kind of right there. So these are all like some of my pro model boards. These fucking stacks, and it just. That's a good one. Gotta do it. And this guy, that's one of my favorite ones. My first foundation ad in the mag, going pro. And it just ended up as a photo, and it said going pro. This is probably the only photo of me with another pro skateboarder, kind of fanning out, like stoked.
I mean, the guys I looked up to were jackasses. I mean, dudes getting paid to party, to skate, to fuck shit up. And so to be 13 and being around drugs, drinking, destruction, everything else, it probably actually fucked me up quite a bit if you think about it.
And so then as a 34-year-old looking back now, then, man, I was fucked up.
My skateboarding has never been planned out. I like to just go skating down the street, and if you see something that looks fun, you skate it. And that's kind of how this double set was, is we were already having fun that day skating. I just wanted to go skating. Something big, it was fun at the time. That's like the best thing about skateboarding. It's just, it's an adventure. Like, you got these four tires that just take you anywhere. I think every skateboarder has that same, like, sense of adventure. They just want to go out and explore. There was no joy out of, like, performing stunts anymore. I did that as a teenager, up until I was, like, 24. But after that, I wanted to kind of, you know, evolve my skating. I wanted to progress in a different way. So, me skating right now is seriously probably just like it was when I was 10 through 16. Pushing down the sidewalk, finding a speed bump to skate, finding a curb, a loading dock, whatever. The CVS, I waxed those curbs 22 years ago. It's kind of funny that 20 years later, I still go and skate those curbs. And so it reminds me of when I was a kid. It's weird to think when, like, someone like me, who's a quite confused, scared person myself, and then you have somebody that looks up to you, it just makes you feel crazy. It's like, wow. It's just a trip to think that that any success came out of it for me riding a skateboard, because I didn't skate to get famous. I didn't skate to prove anything to anybody. It was just because I liked to do it. I mean, that's all I wanted to do, was go skate. Knowing that I've inspired somebody is the best feeling in the entire world. There's nothing better, no better feeling to me than knowing somebody caught some inspiration from me and it made them do what they want to do. So, Mom, Dad.
Need more lighter fluid or something.
My brothers and I with our Speedos, probably like 89. Thank you.
talk to you later.
All right, cool.